sticky tacky. Hi, hi, hi.
In heaven there is no beer, that's why we drink it here. And when we've gone from here, our friends will be drinking all the beer. Im Himmel da gibt's kein Bier, drum trinken wir es hier. Und sind wir nicht mehr hier, dann trinken die anderen unser Bier. Quiet Rocks!
We'll be right back. Hey, everybody, come on in. It's time for the Lustig Tours Holiday Staycation. Yay!
Woohoo.
Well, okay. At this moment, we were going to be in Germany, probably unpacking our suitcases.
Oh, then in case, boohoo.
Yeah, we were going to be over there unpacking our suitcases because we will have been traveling from Leipzig to Berlin today and stopping in Wittenberg to see the Martin Luther Hochzeits Festival. But alas, we're all here at home, but we're here with you, and we're going to play some fun songs and show you some pictures and some fun things from some of our past trips. And we're just going to party together. A lot of people already have a beer, Ross.
Really?
Yes.
Well, do we
and
need,
and
do
Frank
we need...
said he was going to buy a round for the house.
Oh, my goodness.
I mean, this is a house of all these people from all over the country, even across the border.
That's a pretty large house.
Yeah, that is a big...
Or Frank, maybe he just meant our house.
And Frank's a musician, so we know he's not rich.
Maybe he just meant our house.
Oh, maybe he just meant our house. Oh, well, let's get toasted together. And then we'll play some songs and have some fun.
Ein Prosit, der Gemütlichkeit. Ein Prosit, der Gemütlichkeit. Uns, zwei, drei, Sofa! Zicke-zacke-zicke-zacke! 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 Prost!
Drink it up.
Well, did you make mention of our cover photo at
did
all?
Did I make mention of our cover photo at all? Our cover photo today are a conglomeration of several different things. On the left-hand side of your screen, you see some hats with pins on them. Those are some friends of ours. The top photo is... Doug and Cheryl Soltenfuss's traveling hats and all the pins of all the places they've been, sitting on top of their beer drinking hats. And then underneath you see Dale wearing his traveling hat with all the pins from where he's been. And on the right hand side of the screen, the start screen, you saw some
We broke out some of our childhood toys.
We still have light brights in the closet.
Yeah.
So we made the happy face and the sad face that flashes at the bus when Helmut goes a little bit too fast. And when he's going a little bit too fast, it gives us a big red sad face. And everybody in the bus yells out, sad face. And then when we're going the right speed, when we slow down to exactly the speed limit, we get the green happy face. And everybody goes, happy face.
Well, on the bus, we're always happy.
On the bus, we're always happy, even if the sad face shows up. And Helmut, well, as far as we know, he hasn't gotten a ticket.
Yeah.
He hasn't told us if he did.
Well, some things are best left unknown. Let's play some music.
Auf der Autobahn.
Okay. We'll be right back. forgot the most important sound.
What's the most important sound? Oh, I forgot about the horn! It's kind of a loud, obnoxious horn. We bought that on our honeymoon, didn't we? Jawohl. Good to see everybody out there. I saw tons of names flash up on the screen. Lucy Fulton of Lucy and Ken, I think. Is that the right name? I hope I've got that right. They play Irish folk music. I saw them out there in the crowd. Frank from...
Are you having a senior moment?
I'm always having senior moments. I've never been good with names.
Boy, what are you going to do when you are a senior?
But I'm going to use it as an excuse. Frank from the Austrian Boys Band is out there tonight. David Bolt is out there tonight. Let's see. That means that Michelle is also there. Annette up in Tulsa, she says she likes my outfit. Do you like Ross's too? I mean, this is as loud as he's dressed in a long time. Usually when we go on vacation,
well,
he hides.
I don't know. Maybe they can't.
He has on his Hawaiian shirt and his lederhosen. And
my comfortable shoes from...
Yeah, you bought those in Austria, didn't you?
Oh, yeah.
And his Germany hat that he bought from Sepp, our friend who lives half of the year in Florida and half of the year in the Bodensee area, who actually introduced us to the bus company that we use for our tours. So,
well,
and they
actually
played for us on
yeah.
one of our trips. They played for us on our 2016 trip. They came and played in the wine cellar for us. And they play in Tulsa. That's where we met them, actually. Sepp is always selling something. So you're taking the accordion off. You're about to do something, aren't you?
No, I was just trying to show off my shirt.
Oh, okay. Well, let's play another song.
You were
song.
Making such a big deal about it.
I was.
Well, maybe they actually would want to see the shirt.
Mary Flory's with us. Jessica, Michael, and Wade are with us. Oh, all the fun we've had with all these people. Rodney's with us. Erlene is with us from the Texas Polka News. Jimmy is with us. Jimmy Fiviel. Olga is with us. Patricia Kaiser is with us. Holly Thomas is with us. Yavol, we got a lot of friends in the house. I think I saw, there's Cheryl. Cheryl's here. Cheryl says you need to get closer to the camera because they can't see the designs on your Hawaiian shirt.
Oh, all right, well, it's not exactly a Hawaiian shirt.
It's kind of, well, I don't know how to describe it otherwise, though.
It's a comfortable shirt.
Very.
That would be the way to describe it. It's a comfortable
shirt. Okay, so
shirt.
Go up close to the camera so they can see what your shirt looks like. It's a little bit loud. I mean, it's loud if you look at it up close, I guess. I hope it shows up in the lighting over there. You're kind of in front of the studio lights. Oh, show off your muscles. Yeah, well. So we had a request last week, and I don't want to put it off, even though you already heard it in the background music before we started. And this is a song on the cowbells called Das ist Lustig. We named our band after this song. And actually, our very first tour to Europe was as a guest musician with the Alpenfest Oktoberfest tour back in 2011. And
I guess you'd say our first.
Well, our first time over there.
First time over
kids.
There taking instruments and things.
Yes, yes. Yeah, we've both been going to Germany and the Netherlands and Switzerland and Austria for
years
with our families. But the first time we went over and took instruments and entertained, and we helped bring some of the clients that year. Alpenfest invited us back in 2011 to join them for their Rhine and Flames and Oktoberfest tour. And so we were like, yes, of course. And so we got to go to that. But the reason I'm talking about that is because we're going to show you some pictures of it in a few minutes. But also, Das ist Lustig was one of our favorite songs that Alpenfest played. It's a Slavko Ovsenik piece. It's actually a Slovenian song. But Alpenfest always played this song, and Mike Barker played it on the cowbells. And we just love it, and it means that's fun or that's funny, that's amusing. Mm-hmm. Words of the song are all about going out on a Sunday afternoon and having wine and flirting with all the boys. And, you know, it's just
No. It's about going. Look at the actual text. It's about the guy going out and flirting with all the ladies.
The girl goes out and flirts with the boys.
Not in my book.
Takes two to tango, I mean.
Maybe I'll pull up the chart and put it on the camera so they know.
So anyway, we're going to play the cowbells to Das ist Lustig. Are ringing
still?
I can't hear anything.
That's because your ears. No one else can in the neighborhood.
Well, the neighbors are knocking on the door actually right now. I wonder what they want.
I don't know. They want us to play some more music.
They want us to play some more music. Well, there's Linda, there's Teresa. Canada's in the house. Oh, Annette, sorry. Choctaw, not Tulsa. But we see you in Tulsa, and that's the most recent place we saw you. I get those things all confused all the time. If I wouldn't drink so much, it would help, wouldn't it? Don in Tulsa is watching. Don and his daughter, Robbie, and his grandson, Max, her son, Max. They're on tonight.
Oh, are they in Tulsa, yeah. Or are they Choctaw as well?
They're just outside of Choctaw. They're on the northwest side of Oklahoma City. I can't remember the area that they're from. I can't remember the name of it. But anyway, they're in the house too. Yeah. So if y'all have a request, go ahead and type it in and let us know what you want to hear. Of course, if it's a song we don't know how to play, we'll either stumble through it.
Well, let's while we're getting some requests to come in, why don't we play Barbara?
The Barbara Polka sounds like a good idea.
And maybe we could look at some pictures.
Yeah. Festival, they're in the house. polka. We've got some requests coming in, Ross.
All right.
Jawohl. A couple of people have said that the sound seems like it's a little bit behind the video. I wonder what's happening there. Maybe a Facebook thing. We noticed that with Alex's show the other day, too, that everything was like a Chinese movie. The words and the music was just like half of a measure behind whatever he was doing. And I don't know if there's anything we can do about that. I think it's a Facebook thing that we can't.
We can't fix that because on our end, everything is working. But if there's lag.
Hopefully it's not too bad. Just drink more beer. It'll look normal. Anyway, we said we were going to show our first little slideshow. So,
yes.
Yeah. Why don't you bring up the 2011 trip when we went to Europe with Alpenfest.
For Oktoberfest.
Yeah. We were over there for the Rhine and Flames, the last one that happens at the end and the beginning of September, and some wine tastings. And then we went to Oktoberfest in Munich, like the real deal, like the one, the only, the granddaddy.
Yeah,
the one that it all started out as a wedding reception. And the whole city of Munich was invited out back in 1810. And of course, at that time, it was in October. And after 2 weeks of drinking all the beer that was available in Munich, and someone told me that that was Paul Honor Brewery that offered that beer. I may not be correct on that. So if you guys know the history, feel free to correct me because sometimes I get those things confused. Beer's beer, right? It's all really good beer. But anyway, so we got to go and it's still a party this year. It's been canceled. It's only been canceled a few years over the past 200, but it's a big festival. So is it running? Can they still hear us talking?
It's running. They should be able to hear us talking. And
okay. Well, I'm going to move
the
mic where I can see
the. I think you missed a couple of pictures already.
Oh, I already missed a couple of pictures. Okay. There is Mike and Diana and Nancy and Doug and Cheryl, I think, sitting at a table. There's Nancy and Cheryl and Diana, I think. I really can't see the pictures very well from here.
Well,
look, there's Ross and me kissing in the street. right after I bought that drinking hat.
The Night Watchman.
The Night Watchman with Mike and Diana.
In
Rotenburg. Yeah, we got to see the Night Watchman in Rotenburg. He told us all about the poop in the streets. And there's my mom and dad. Daddy's being naughty, as usual. They're wearing our shirts, the first design we had, with the Prost y'all. There's my brother with schnapps caps attached to every part of his body that sticks out. There's my dad in my new hat. Is he taking a nap? Are his eyes closed?
His eyes are closed.
I think he's asleep. And I just stuck my hat on his head. There is that you and me?
That's at Teo's.
That's at Teo's, and we were drinking all that schnapps that his dad made. Oh,
we were
drinking all that. Oh, and there's the wine tasting. I don't remember much from that day. It was a good day, though. Oh, and there we are on the boat. Yeah, waiting for the fireworks to start. Of course, the sun had to go down first. But the food was good, and is that
that's
more
on
the
Rhine boat.
That's on the Rhine boat, okay. Was that day? It was kind of rainy part of the day. All lit up, yeah,
lit up.
With flames and lights.
Can't hear me, so you may have to.
Yeah, all lit up. There we are, back to that first picture that we started at. So, yeah, that was back in 2011 when we got to go to Oktoberfest. Thankfully, no one had a picture of me dancing on the table at noon. I mean, somebody had to. That's a tradition at Oktoberfest. You're supposed to get up on the tables and dance, right? Apparently not in the Festzelt tradition. Yeah, that got looked at funny. But it's okay. I was embarrassing my country.
Well, you did that at the Hofbräuhaus, which...
I didn't embarrass our country at the Hofbräuhaus. We all embarrassed our country at the Hofbräuhaus. There was a whole team of us that did that. Actually, we've done that a couple of times. What was it last week we were talking about getting arrested in Germany?
We never got arrested.
No, we've never gotten arrested, but we've gotten into trouble. We've been fussed at in the Hofbräuhaus several times. I remembered there was something I did in 2011, and now I can't remember what it was anymore.
In 2011? I don't know.
Yeah, it was something I did back then that got me in. Oh, yeah, no. Okay, never mind. We're not going to tell you. But we didn't have to get anybody out of jail, so that's good.
I don't even have a clue as to what you're talking about. Maybe somebody bailed you out when I didn't see it. Speaking of the Oktoberfest tour, why don't we play the Munich medley?
The Munich medley. If Cheryl, I can remember, asked for that last
she
week.
She asked for that last week, and I, for some reason, can't seem to remember all the parts, partly because it was fairly recently added to our repertoire, and so I might have to pull the chart out. I'll see if I can do it without.
Do you need your lovely assistant to put the... Oh, it's not in your travel book, is it?
Well, it's probably there somewhere, but I don't know. Let me see what I can do.
All right, from memory, the Munich medley. Get ready to shunkle.
Thank you.
Anus ist gut. Feed ist fett, Geld ist fett, Mädel ist fett. Alles ist kaputt. Du lieber Augustin, alles ist hin. The first sobriety test of the evening.
I think I remembered all the elements.
You did. I think it was all in there.
I had to repeat one. Just
that's okay. But, everybody likes that song.
Everyone knows that song.
So we had a couple requests come in.
Yes.
One of them is Just Because.
Okay.
From Cheryl. One of them is Übernsee, which we have not sung since we recorded our After On the Road Again CD. I don't even know if we have the words to it in our book.
I probably do.
Cool. Now if we can sing it in tune, we'll do it for you.
That's another.
Because we haven't sung it in about 3 years. But you know, we're all drinking
it. We don't have
a pitch
correct for Valina.
No, there's no pitch correct for me. Molly Ness is online tonight, and yeah, she remembers. I just don't sing in tune. Paula Kager. Okay, so none of us can go to Germany this year, but you can go to Fredericksburg, Texas. Commercial break. Go to the Cuckoo's Nest. I think they're open. You can get yourself all decked out. In fact, okay, we're not wearing anything that we've bought at the Cuckoo's Nest. However, 2 weeks ago on Memorial Day, I had on one of the dirndls I had just bought there in February, and she usually has new shipments
I think the
early
week
in the
before
summer.
I was too. I had some Lederhosen jeans.
Yeah, jeans and hosen. So you live in Texas, you want to go to Oktoberfest in Texas, it's 110 degrees outside, you're sweating, you're spilling beer on yourself, you'd really like to wash your Lederhosen. You can get canvas hosen and denim hosen at Cuckoo's Nest in Fredericksburg. So yeah, and a whole lot of other cool stuff too.
Well, like, they got goodies to eat.
They make their own honey. Okay, say they make their own honey. They have their own bees
their
that make
Bob
honey.
Raises honey.
Yeah,
they have a pecan orchard, so they raise pecans as well.
They have
import food from Europe. I mean, Germany as well as, I believe, the Netherlands and Italy and I'm not sure who all is representative, but they have a lot of good food.
And just down the street, there's wineries. And just down the street is Altstadt Beer. So if you go to Fredericksburg, you can get your hurricane survival kit all right there at the Cuckoo's Nest. What?
I'm just trying to remember what you said. We had a couple of requests.
Just Because. Let's do Just Because. Let's do that one first. And then we'll do another German song of some sort. Excuse me. Too much beer all at once.
Just because you think you're so pretty, and just because you think you're so hot, just because you think you got something that nobody else has got. You tease me and you spend all my money.
Cha-ching.
You laugh and call me old Santa Claus. Well, I'm telling you, baby, I'm through with you. Because, just because.
Now, just because you think you're so handsome, and just because you think you're so hot, just because you think you've got something that no other guy has got. Love to let me spend all your money.
No, I don't.
And that's why I keep on hanging round.
You sure do.
Well, I'm telling you, baby, I'm stuck like glue. Just because, lucky strike.
Just because you think you're so pretty.
You're so handsome.
And just because you think you're so hot.
I float sheetrock.
Just because you think you got something that nobody else has got. You tease me and you spend all my money.
Every penny. And that's why I keep on hanging round.
Well, I'm telling you, baby, I'm with you.
That song was written right here in Texas by the Shelton Brothers. It was kind of a Western swingy tune, and then Frankie Yankovic heard it and made it famous, and now everybody plays it. Chardon Polka Band plays it.
You said something about Tumball German Fest being in the house.
I did. Is that... Sandy and Grady are in the house tonight.
Well, I know what Sandra's favorite song is.
I do, too. Actually, she has several favorites, but...
Well, I know the one that I always hear her requesting.
Yeah.
So why don't we put that one in there? That is a good German song.
It is a good German song, written for the movie The Fischerin von Bodensee.
Which, incidentally, is
the... Is a movie written for the song.
Well, no, what I was going to say is the first tour group that we took over there.
That's
in
true.
2016, we went to the Bodensee.
We did.
Lake Constance, for those that know the name in English.
We saw all kinds of cool things.
Yeah.
So here's In Heaven There Is No Beer for Sandra and Tomball.
In heaven there is no beer, that's why we drink it here. And when we're gone from here, all our friends will be drinking all the beer.
Trying Übersee.
I think so. I mean, the worst thing that can happen is we'll sing it out of tune.
Yeah, and
the more you drink, the better we sound. Honestly. Übersee is one of the first songs that we learned how to sing in heavy Austrian dialect. From the Tyrolean, like where Tirol and Bayernland sort of come together.
Do you have it?
I'm looking for it. I think it's in the U's, but knowing the way I alphabetize things, there's no telling.
Knowing you, it's probably in another section of songs to learn or something.
It could be completely out of...
Just put...
Oh, you have it. Okay.
Just Just put your folder away.
Okay. See, Ross makes a better lovely assistant than I do.
And we'll just share the mic. How about that?
We're going to read this down here, right?
Well,
oh, those aren't the words we sing.
Sure it is.
We do this one, and this one. This one, this one. Okay.
There's only one of them that we don't do. Just stay away from number three. Can you match it?
I don't know. Does that match?
Uben zeta magi diru meshima ri tu yeri ho da diri tu yeri ho da tsak hi mai shwa ga chan de mi ma ri tu yeri ho da diri da tsak hi mai shwa ga chan de mi ma ri tu yeri ho da diri Üben sei flag gemein taun, ri, tu yeri go da di ri, tu yeri go, muss amal ubisch van fetten zum Clown, ri, tu yeri go da di ri, muss amal ubisch van fetten zum Clown, ri, tu yeri go da di ri. Mit am See mag das Wasser andral, ri, tereri ho, da di ri, tereri ho, getzog, da man hat dik dik setzel anmal, ri, tereri ho, da di ri, getzog, mein dein auf dik dik setzel anmal, ri, to yeri go da diri.
Did I stay in tune?
We'll find out later.
Thanks for asking for that, Cheryl. It actually felt good to sing it. I love that song.
Oh, yeah. Give me that back.
There's your book.
So before, you know, I was thinking maybe we would talk about 2016. But
yeah,
before we do, you know, we were talking about In Heaven There Is No Beer.
We were.
Well, there's another song associated with that movie.
That's true. Well, actually, the movie was written for the song. And then the song was
The song the existed, then the movie was written. But then they had to write some additional songs. So that's when In Heaven There Is No Beer came into the picture. Is that right?
Yes, I think that's how it goes.
Okay. So there was a song called Die Fischerin from Bodensee. Or the Fisher Lady.
The Fisher Lady from Lake Constance.
Yeah.
But you know what? We found out that the song is sort of a lie because the song says Ein Weißer Schwan,
one white swan.
And when we were there, there were two.
There were at least two. I think they typically go in pairs anyway, don't they?
I was so aggravated that they told me a lie. I texted Kevin Hatcher and I said, Kevin, there are two white swans in the Fisherin from Bodensee, not just one. And he wrote me back and he said, I was trying to sleep because jet lag, you know, the whole time difference.
Why did you wake Kevin up? He already works late hours.
Because he works nights and I thought he'd be awake. Anyway, enough about that.
Anyway, I know this is the Wilsons. One of the Wilsons' favorite songs.
Yeah. Here's Ross.
Am schönen
And that's one of Rodney Van Outerkirk's favorite as well. Rodney and New Braunfels. Yeah.
Wonderful.
Okay, Joanne is in the house again, Ross.
Wow.
I didn't want to tell you before that song. That's one of the ones he practices the most.
We may have to do something special for Joanne.
We do. And I saw some other names I haven't seen in a long time. Katie Nelson from the Das ist keine Kunst German Folk Dance Group is in here tonight. And let's see, Christina Lewis, who used to travel with the Dutch Folk Dance Group when we were all kids, she's in here tonight.
Oh my goodness.
Mike and Karen from Tomball are also online. Let's see, Lee Nowak is in the house. Leanne from back, we did two Oktoberfests in the Woodlands with the Rotary Club, and Leanne from the Rotary Club is in the house tonight. This is like a big reunion. Ginger Gritzius is out there. She's in Brenham, Texas now. She had been in San Leon for a long time, and after, was it Ike that took out that whole part of the city? And we went out there and played for a fundraiser. I can't remember. I think I have that right. So we are going to now take you to our 2016 trip, the first Lustig Tours holiday trip going overseas. We went to the southern part of Baden-Württemberg and stayed along the Bodensee, like Ross said, for about 5 nights. And then we moved hotels and stayed in southern Bavaria, just over the mountain from Oberammergau in a little town called Etal. I can never pronounce it correctly because I keep wanting to pronounce it American and not Austrian, Bavarian. Anyway, so here's some photos from that trip coming up. Sitting where I can see the screen a little bit better, I think. Is it up there yet? Oh, there we go. There's our bus. Is that Jessica getting on there?
That's
and
Jessica,
our
giving the duck bunny ears.
There's a group photo, yeah. I don't know if the crazy Lithuanian waiter is in that photo. He's in one of the photos. Beer crossing. Look, you know, basically when we went to the Schussenrieder Brauerei, when you come in, they have these warning signs. Oh, Jimmy and Linda celebrated their honeymoon on our first trip back in 2016. They're in the house tonight, too. And their anniversary is coming up in just a few days on July 2nd.
And you just can't take the kiddies
in. No, we have not really ever outgrown. There's the parade in Garmisch right before the festival. We went on opening day, so there were a lot of fun things going on in the tent. There's Brian and Tammy having a beer.
At the festival.
Yeah, at the festival, in the Festzelt. Right before we started pounding the tables and standing up and going crazy, and everybody around
Wilson
us was like,
Helmut?
Yeah, there's the Wilsons. Is Helmut in there too? Yeah, Helmut's in there too. He was driving that night.
He was drinking Coke.
Oh, okay. There's Wade and his mom, Jessica.
And your brother.
Is my brother in there too? I can't see my brother.
out in the streets of Marysville.
Oh, that was what I was going to tell y'all about. That happened. Okay, we were playing music on the street in Marysburg. We had permission from the restaurant to play. The restaurant had talked to the city council. Yes, it was okay that these people from America were going to play music on the street corner, and we still got shut down. We were asked to leave because we had played longer than 15 minutes or something. And yeah, but
well, the only person that asked us to leave was a kiosk.
It was a kiosk guy.
And we were actually bringing business to him.
We were. There were people coming to. There were people from locals who were singing along to the German folk music that we were playing. And of course, we were both. Oh, look, there's Ross. Oh, he passed out after eating a bag of cherries.
sugar shock.
But yeah, we've had some fun on this trip. So anyway, the kiosk guy got mad. The restaurant told us, well, you have to stop playing. But at some point during the time that we were out there playing for our guests, because they were all sitting around the area where we were playing, somebody put my auto harp case down on the ground and people started putting money in it. And I think in like the 30 minutes that the auto harp case was down on the ground, we made 35 euros. So the next morning we went schnapps shopping and passed things around the bus to taste. That was a lot of fun too. Kind of started a trend in our tours. Every tour we go on, we pick up some of the local flavors and pass them around the bus. So we don't get schnockered, but we do get schnapped up just a little bit.
Well, speaking of that festzelt we were in, we have a little video.
Is it working?
It kind of got corrupted a little bit, but it sort of works.
Well, go ahead and play it. It's a video that Margaret and Dale took.
I don't know if they heard a thing I said. You're gonna
The video that Ross is about to play, somehow we downloaded it and it was working, but then when we put it through the production thingy-majig here,
it never worked.
Oh, it never worked right. Well, they also had trouble downloading it. So anyway, here is part of a video that Margaret and Dale took of the Festzelt. Of course, the big brass band is playing all the traditional beer drinking songs and the Schunkellieder, and the folk dance group was taking a break. So they're up there on the stage schunkeling with each other, trying to keep their legs warm so they can come out and do another dance. So there we were having some fun in the tent, schunkeling after a couple of beers. The part where the video froze after that, when they went into the song, Auf und nieder in my vida, da 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 da. I don't know all the words yet, but it's one of those songs we have to learn. The tables from America, the three tables of all of us, we were the first ones to be going up and down with the song. And just up and down.
It was up and down,
left and right is a different one. Well, they did that one. But anyway, the one in the video is just up and down and up and down. No, not left and right. You have to watch the video again. It's just Auf und nieder.
Auf und nieder. I can't watch the video again. It doesn't play right.
Anyway, let me tell
you. That's
what
I've been trying to tell you.
I know.
The video doesn't play right on anything that we have.
He's not had enough beer yet. I'm trying to tell the story, though. The three tables from Texas, we knew the song, we knew how it goes, and we were all going up and down like right away, like we were on cue. And that actually, I think maybe on Margaret's page, the video may be loaded up there if you're surfing around on Facebook and you go to Margaret's page. The video is there, and you can, I think it all shows, so maybe we'll see if we can link it up on our page and show it to you later after the show. But anyway, we Texans knew what to do thanks to Alpenfest and Die Sauerkrauts and Lorelei and Shotzi and Terry Cavanaugh and the Alpine Express and all these other in Alpen Musikant and all these bands here in Texas that have taught us how to do these crazy things. So
anyway,
what's next?
I don't know if Joanne is still in the house.
Is Joanne still in the house? Joanne, if you're still there, Ross is about to play something for you. I don't know what it's going to be.
Oh, I'm sure you'll figure it out.
I'll figure it out.
Thank you.
Dankeschön, merci beaucoup.
And the crowd went wild!
The German that immigrated to France and...
Changed his name. I've gotten so hyper tonight I lost an earring.
Jacques Offenbach. You lost an earring. I knew I saw something go flying. I wasn't sure what it was.
That's why I don't wear earrings on stage much. Because I lose things like that.
Anyway, we played that special for Joanne. Joanne was my college professor, my accordion college professor, to be specific.
Up there in Kansas City.
Up in Kansas City, Missouri.
Yeah.
And she had to put up with me for a few years.
Hey, she helped make it possible for you to get to travel with the accordion orchestra because you could repair anything.
Well, I don't know if she knew that or not, but I think I had to repair a few things and we figured it out that it was possible. You know, that reminds me of an interesting story. You know, I had this little bag that I had all these tools in, you know, X-Acto knives, screwdrivers of various sizes, pliers, soldering iron, solder, reed wax, which is, let's just say that was my carry-on luggage at the time.
Beeswax with stuff in it, rosin or resin.
You know, nowadays I think they would frown upon it if I tried to go through security with
that.
They
already look at us weird through security because I have an auto harp.
Yeah, that's right. They really, most of the time, they don't worry so much about the accordion, but the auto harp is another story.
Hey, that one time I flew to Singapore to do an Oktoberfest in Penang, Malaysia, I had my cowbells and my carry-on, and they made me take them out and play them.
I guess they wanted to hear some music.
Yeah, I guess. But at that point, I had been flying for 30 hours, and I wasn't sure I could play anything.
But, you know, nowadays you carry reed wax, they might think it's plastic explosive or something, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, enough bad stuff. Let's keep it happy. I want to keep it happy. I got to keep it happy.
Oh, I didn't realize we were going that way.
we were talking about getting into trouble.
Can be happy as long as you don't really get in trouble.
Yeah. Yeah. The good kind of mischief. Like, okay, Diana wanted to know why we skipped one of the pictures that they sent for the 2011 trip. The one where I was shaking hands with the guys. I really was just shaking hands, but we didn't show the picture because, I have students that watch some of these videos and it's probably best that we don't share that. So, amongst mixed company. But I mean, there was nothing untoward. It just looked like it was naughty.
Yeah.
And Ross was right there. It's not like anything was happening. He was.
Anyway, let's go into happy things. Not, you said happy things.
That was happy.
Yeah.
We were all cracking up.
What are we going to play? Let's play some music.
Okay. Well, we had another request. Mom asked for a love song.
Okay.
Because she said we should have played it last week for the professor.
We just played a love song.
We did. That's true. Wait. Yeah, I guess it is a love song. Last week we were doing an anniversary song for Professor Katzenjammer.
That's right.
And Mom said, why didn't you play a Kilibidi for him? And I said, because we didn't think about it, because it wasn't on the list. And as it is, we didn't get to all the requests.
Well, and he may not know that song anyway.
That's true.
That wasn't one he requested.
But we're going to play it anyway, because it's one of the ones that we typically play on our tours when we're overseas. Everybody dances to it. It's kind of a two-step. It's a love song. Ich liebe dich.
Ich liebe dich.
Ich liebe dich.
Nothing says I love you like ich liebe dich.
Ich liebe dich. You have to say it with real German accent.
I did.
No, like Helmut would say it.
I did.
Oh. Okay.
Nobody goes, ich liebe dich.
Sure they
Unless
do.
they're why can't I think of the name of the band? Du hast.
Rammstein.
Rammstein, yeah.
Might say it.
If you're Rammstein, they might say ich liebe dich. But otherwise they say ich liebe dich.
Ich liebe dich. Okay. So we're gonna play a love song. And then we're gonna show you some more pictures. Mm-hmm. nicht ein blondes Haar. Und an dein blaues Augenpaar. Und dann haben wir den ersten Tanz getanzt. Dann war es meinem Herzen klar. Liebe dich. In meinen Träumen bist nur du. So, in my dreams, it's you and you alone, and in my arms, you'll always be blessed. I love you so. I want to give you everything, because to me, you're my sunshine. My heart is overflowing. See, my eyes are glowing, because I love you so. Oft hatte ich im Leben schwer. Lief das Pech mir hinterher. Doch nun fand ich bei dir das große Glück. Und das verlässt mich niemals mehr. Liebe dich. In meinen Träumen bist nur du. Show them some photos from 2017 when we went to the Rhine in Flames again. We had so much fun in 2011 with Alpenfest that we wanted to repeat that part of their trip. So we went to some of the wineries along the Mosel and we went to see the Rhine in Flames. We saw Burg Eltz Castle and the Marksburg Castle. Did a lot of other fun things as well. We hung out in Rüdesheim for all day. The day we had jet lag. I think there's a picture of all of us jet lagged and snot schnockered sitting around a table listening to Dieter Lachschmidt right there on the Rhine River. And we watched the fireworks that night. And then after that, we went to Rothenburg ob der Tauber and stayed for six nights, I think, and Bamberg and Würzburg, and we went to a lot of other places as well. We had a lot of fun in 2017. So here's the pictures from that vacation. Oh, there we are. Is that all of us sitting around that table listening to Dieter? Oh, and there's the fireworks on the Rhine. Ross's camera took good pictures of the fireworks. My brother's did too, but he didn't submit any photos. So let's see. I can't see that one. Is that at Burg Eltz?
Yes.
Okay. That's our group photo from 2017, standing in front of the, sort of in front of the castle.
Oh, and there, that was Hans's.
That's Helmut's 50th birthday. We brought him a cowboy hat. And he was just thrilled. And I can't see that photo at all.
Margaret.
Oh, that's Margaret. Oh, and that's when she found a wine that she actually liked. She's not much of a wine drinker.
Storming the wall
in Rothenburg. We were playing The Happy Wanderer and singing and walking and having a good old time. There we are on the Mosel River. Is that inside one of the locks? I can't tell from here. Just in case you were wondering who goes where and how, they make sure that there's no questions. There we are wearing our Polka On t-shirts in Bamberg. We had a really good tour guide there. Got to see most of the inner part of the city. Let's see. That's the residence in Würzburg where they taught us about princess steps in the palaces. And there's...
And there you got framed.
Yeah, there, Jessica and I are framed. I wonder what we got framed for. Having too much over at that little brewery, probably. Yeah, well, so that was 2017. Just a few of the memories from it. We've had a lot of fun on all these trips, and somehow we found Rodelbahns on all of them, too. But we'll get to that later with one of Carl's videos. So,
well, I know we had a request for a song that we've kind of been muddling through. We haven't.
Well, did you see it? Did you see the request for 99 Luftballons?
No.
Then there's two requests for songs that we've been muddling through.
we don't play the 99 Luftballons.
Not really. I mean, we trip and fall through it. Stuart asked for that one.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
But the other one was the cafe.
Oh yeah, the cafe polka. That's right. It is on here, isn't it? The E I E I E I E I E I E I E I O. Frank in Connecticut asked for this song, and our friends in Canada love this one as well. But I'm not going to sing Teresa's words from when she was a teenager. I just can't do that with a straight face.
Boy, I can't even remember what key I did it in for you.
I certainly don't remember which key, because I forgot to ask you. Hey, hey, ba-ba-dee-ba. really need a beer now. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Hey!
Hey, let's drink some beer now. It tastes really good now. Hey, let's get some more beer now. Yeah, 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 yeah. Because that felt really good in my vocal range, at least tonight. Oh, you picked the key of A.
F.
Oh, F.
F
or A. I can't tell from here because I can't see. Oh, F. Key of F. Okay, remember.
As in Frank. F.
F. F is in Frank from Connecticut, who asked for
yes.
that song. Yeah, well, yeah, we also had a request for 99 Luftballons, but I told Stuart that that was one of those that we didn't really
Well, maybe we'll
after another beer,
attempt
maybe.
That if we get some time, but let's play something that we know first.
Let's see. Oh, I think it's time for some interactive stuff.
Okay.
We have not done the bench dance with you yet.
Can we do
there
that?
In YouTube world. I think we can. So... Are you all seated? Everybody's sitting
Speaking
around a table or on a
don't
couch.
Play anymore.
You have a oh, he says we haven't played it in a few months. Yeah, we haven't played it in a few months. This is one you really need at least like a partner for. I don't have a partner, so I'll be playing it with you out there on the TV. So bench dance. Actually, and we developed this one it's like 4 or 5 years ago, I think. It's based on a traditional German folk dance from Bavaria and Austria that the guys do with a bench, and they slam the bench on the floor and they jump up on the bench and they patty cake with each other and then they slap each other and then they tug of war and then they do all this stuff and yodel.
I
so,
can't even remember how that song goes.
Oh.
Can you sing it? That's not very helpful.
I know that part. It's probably in the wrong key. But.
Not very helpful, but I think
I never
I
sing it in the right
out.
Key. He has perfect pitch. I don't. Okay, so we're going to stomp our feet on the floor 3 times. And then we're going to pound our hands on our knees or on the table 3 times. And then we're going to jump up and go, yoo-hoo! And then we're going to patty cake with whoever's sitting across from us or next to us like this. Or like this, if they're sitting there with 3 people, or just slap the computer screen so you can be my partner. Okay? Here we go. Auf geht's! Und stomp! Und pound! Cake, stomp! Und pound! This is a patty cake part too. Are y'all yodeling? Here we go. Here we go. One stomp, one pound. Yoo-hoo-wee. Patty cake, stomp, one pound. Yoo-hoo-wee. Patty cake, stomp, one pound. Yoo-hoo-wee. Patty cake, stomp. One more time. One stomp. One pat. Yoo-hoo-wee. Patty cake. Yoo-hoo-wee. what a lot of do what a lot of do yahoo do. Hey, that's the bench dance. Now you guys have a way of practicing it before we all get back together at Oktoberfest this fall. Yeah, well.
Why don't we play something we halfway know?
Play something we halfway know? Where's the fun in that? Hey! Awesome. Frank said, that's the Hightower.
That's right.
Okay, so here in Texas, we have a German language contest every year in February and March for the German students in Texas in school. And one of the categories, there's like 50 categories now of different things that the kids can compete with. One of the categories is German folk dance. And about 5 or 6 years ago, there was a push to start doing an Einzeltanz where you have just one couple compete so that schools who didn't have enough kids in the German program could still do folk dance even if they didn't have enough to make a folk dance group. So we added the Einzeltanz to the contest so the kids could learn, and that was the first folk
which
dance.
Which uses the Hightower music.
They actually have four dances that they rotate through, so you don't have a student from 1 year who did the dance go to the next year and do the same dance and have an advantage over a student who didn't do that dance the year before. So every 4 years, the Hightower comes back around. I can't remember what the other ones are. I think Luzerner Landler is one of the ones that's in the con. Anyway, more folk dance news than most of you guys understand. But it's just cool to know that in the school systems here in Texas, at least until COVID hit, The German students are learning how to do German folk dance and play German folk music in a polka bands, and I think it's just really cool.
Well, it's something when you're playing at a restaurant and a group of kids come
running up and they start dancing
and they know the folk dances.
Yeah.
Well, and then they tell you that they're in the German club at their school, but also then one of them proceeded to tell us that they were in this Spanish club, but she's like, I think I'm going to start taking German. Y'all have much more fun.
Yes. Yes, the German culture is way more fun. We work harder and we play harder. We definitely party harder. We had a request several weeks ago for the hat song, and this is back when right after we got our internet upgraded, but apparently our Facebook still hadn't caught up to our internet upgrade, and Facebook, right before we started playing the song, we didn't know that it had gone off air. We thought we were still playing a concert, so we played the hat song for ourselves. And I realized this as I was going through some of the old videos. I'm like, the hat song, it never came up. Mike Sunlightner asked for the hat song weeks ago, and we thought we played it for him. We didn't. But tonight, since we're doing our tours, we play the hat song, and we'll use some of the hats that we've collected pins over the years. Actually, let's see, where's your hat? It's over here. Off camera.
Well, not exactly. It's difficult to get to.
So we have Ross's hat. We should have set up the scooter cam for this. I could do a close-up of the hats, but oh well. So there's that one. There's, this is one of mine. Tons and tons of pins on it.
That hat must be too heavy. I don't think I've ever seen you wear it.
It smashes the ponytail. Oh. Looks really funny if you wear it like that. And then there's this one. This is the summertime hat. I got it in Salzburg. Put more pins on it.
See, what you need right now is a lazy Susan to put that on, so you can just.
And okay, so y'all saw that picture of Ross and I back in 2016. I had just bought this hat, and there was nothing on it except the braids.
And rumor has it that all those are bottle caps and corks and things from beverages that you drank over the course of the trip.
I can't remember anything from the trip, but I have a hat that tells me what I drank. And I also somehow managed to get one of the name tags, actually, one of the identification tags.
That must
tags
have been a year or so after.
No, this was in 2011.
Well, you added some stuff to it, because the Oktoberfest tour, that badge you got there is from the...
That's from 2011.
No.
I bought that from... I took that from the guy.
Oh, wait
in
a minute.
The festival.
I was on the 2011 tour.
Yeah, you were there. You were there with me when I asked him if I could have his name tag, and he said I can sell it to you.
Maybe we both drank all of that.
See, our waiters in Germany, they know how to get money from Americans, because I had to have that.
Sorry, I was going back to 2007.
No, that hat's upstairs, and there is a few Worst Fest drinks on there, too.
Yeah.
Or at least drinks I drank at the hotel during Worst Fest. Anyway, so let's do the hat song, and somehow I'll tell you a little bit about all the junk on all these hats. Hat, Dreiecken, ein, zwei, drei. Dreiecken hat mein Hut. Und hat nicht Dreiecken, ein, zwei, drei, dann wär es nicht mein Hut. Mein Hut, hat ein kleines Berchtesgaden-Pin. Ein kleines Berchtesgaden-Pin. Berchtesgaden is the city below Eagle's Nest. It's way up high and Berchtesgaden is down. Dann wär es nicht mein Hut. Mein Hut, hat ein kleines Stadttechte. Stadttechte pin. Hat mein Hut, jawohl. It's right next to the Tombow pin. And those are sister cities. Tombow Techte, jawohl. Das ist nicht mein Hut. Ein kleines Kölner Dom hat mein Hut. Although the real dome is like a million billion meters high and a million billion meters wide. It's huge. Das ist nicht mein Hut. Mein Hut. Ein kleines Paulaner München-Button. Ein kleines, großes Paul an a München, but not mein Hut, jawohl. John gave us this a couple of years ago at the Addison Oktoberfest. Wer ist nicht mein Hut? Mein Hut, der hat ein kleines Salzburg-Welten a pin. With the, we went down the salt mine slides last year, and that was a lot of fun. I don't know what else to say about it. Mein Hut.
It was salty.
It was salty. Don't lick the walls. That's what I have to say about it.
I tried to tell you.
Mein Hut, der hat ein kleines Cow. Ein kleines Cow hat mein Hut, jawohl. Moo, diddle-o-dee, dann werd es nicht mein Hut. Ein kleines Pin from the Passionsspiele in Oberammergau. Passionsspiele in Oberammergau. Hat mein Hut, jawohl. We got to see the behind-the-scenes tour of the theater. Oh my goodness, that was so awesome. Don't wait, it's nicht mein Hut. Mein Hut, der hat ein kleines... What's that called again?
A Zeppelin.
Oh, a Zeppelin. I keep thinking dirigible, and that's not the right word. A Zeppelin, because we went to the Zeppelin Museum. Das ist nicht mein Hut. Ein kleines mountain climber in the Parknachklamm. A kleines mountain climber in the Parknachklamm. Hat mein Hut. You know, Carl Henderson, he walked all the way to the top of the Klamm with us. That was like a 2-hour hike. Sneak mein Hut. He's our teenager. He can keep up with anybody. And lots of drinks on it. Lots of drinks on it. Hot mein Hut. Some of them on the bus, some of them in the hotel room, some of them at the Oktoberfest. And I don't remember what this guy looked like, but I took his name tag. Das nicht mein Hut. Kleines Prostjahl boot. Ein kleines Prostjahl boot hat mein Hut. Jawohl. Prostjahl, it's Texanische Deutsch. We designed it ourselves. Wer ist nicht mein Hut? Mein Hut.
So there's all of our...
That's not all, but we really didn't want to keep you all night because there's like a billion pins on those. And that's not even all the hats. We have more upstairs. The storage
upstairs,
room.
Downstairs.
out in the van.
We have many hats.
Yeah. So we had, let's show some pictures from 2018 when we went to the northwestern part of Germany, Techte. We saw the sister city of Tombow, Munster, Germany, and Monschau. And we went to Baston in Belgium. Had a tour of some World War II sites, and then we went to the Netherlands and spent a few days roaming around Amsterdam and eating tulips and drinking, wait, seeing tulips and drinking beer and eating pulvertjes.
Yeah, don't eat tulips, they'll make you sick.
Well, they don't taste very good
either. I think they kill you, actually.
They do? I've eaten a tulip.
When did you eat a tulip?
I chewed on the...
Are you sure?
I was drinking. I was being stupid. Haven't you ever done that? Like, there's a vase of flowers in the
maybe,
table.
Maybe the flowers are not like the bulbs. The bulbs are toxic.
Don't eat the bulb. Yeah, the bulb is
toxic.
Definitely. But I think the petal was, at least I didn't die from it. That may explain some things. But.
Well, yeah, there's other things that explain those things, too.
So let's show them the pictures from 2018. In Holland. Boy, did we laugh on that boat. Had a lot of fun. Uh-oh, there's the Chocomel. Yeah, I drank most of that all by myself. My favorite Dutch beverage. It's a delicious chocolate milk drink. What is that? I can't see from
here.
That
is the silver, the goldsmith.
Oh, the goldsmith in Tehte. Yeah, Grady told us about that. And the man that does all that gold work looks just like Grady. They're like twins. And I can't see again.
It is the...
Is that one of the little pieces that he made?
No. That's that cathedral.
Oh, the cathedral in Aachen. Yes. Yeah, the Aachener Dom, where Charlemagne had... there's Charlemagne's chair. And our amazing guide. That was like one of the best guides we've ever had in one of the churches. He knew his history, and he's a student and super, super enthusiastic about what he was doing. That's at World War II monument in Bastogne. Yeah. And that is all of us walking towards the Mauderslot in Holland. Ah, the poffertjes kraam. Yeah, if you ever want a sugar high in Holland in the summer, just go get some poffertjes. They're delicious. The one in Bussum is the best, I promise. I even got to cook some last year. They let me flip them myself. There we are, all getting our sugar high.
Oh, that looks very cheesy.
What is that? Oh, the cheese market in Gouda. That's a Gouda cheese, a Gouda kaas. Golden cheese. Look at all that good cheese sitting out there. The cheese market, where they show you how they decide what the price is of the cheese, and they argue and they slap each other. And oh, there we go with the pretty tulips. Miles and miles and miles of tulips in Kokenhof. We got to spend the whole day there. And there we are taking our photo with the Rembrandt's Night Watch, which all the statues are standing in Amsterdam. You can take your pictures with them. And there we are, our group photo at the...
Kinderdijk?
No, not Kinderdijk. I can hear my dad yelling the name right now. No. Zaandam. Zaanseschans. So, oh, and there's the bus. My cousin Jan made that for us. He looked at the photos that we had that we use as our sign in the bus. And he said, let me make you a nice wooden bus that you can have every year. So stored over there at the bus company in Germany are 11 fans, because we're Americans and we get hot at night without our air conditioning. And we have also one here at home to look
one
at on the shelf,
and one
over there
in
Meersburg, yeah, at the bus.
The lighting
isn't working. There you go. I think you're visible now. Maybe back a little bit more. Are you too high? I can't see it from here at all. Anyway, so those are some things from 2018. And let's see.
Speaking of, you were making mention of the Rodelbahn.
I was. Oh, do we have Carl's video up?
We do.
Oh, my goodness. Are you guys in for a treat now? Okay, Carl is taking you on all the Rodelbahns he's been on with us. A Rodelbahn is a little single cart roller coaster. And you get on the cart, and I mean, this is Germany, y'all, so you don't sign a waiver. They just tell you to use the brake.
If you get hurt, it's your own
fault. Well, just watch.
We'll be right back.
Yes, thrills and spills and chills on Das's Lustig tours. Carl has never really been injured badly. A couple of times he got a little blood, but Tammy was there to take good care of him and bandaged him up.
Nurse.
She's an ER nurse.
Yes.
Yeah. So when Carl came off of the Rotobahn, he's like, "I'm bleeding." She said, "Oh, I can take care of it." So before we even got on the bus, everybody was all back in one piece. We re-glued his arms back to his body. And ready to go on another Rotobahn. In fact, he said, "If you don't put a Rotobahn on your trips, I'm not going anymore." That every trip we go on, we try to include at least one Rotobahn because those are a lot of fun. So you can see what that's like. And let's play another song. I don't know which one to play. We're gonna have to wrap this up pretty soon. Ross has sound duties at church again in the morning, which means he has to be there before 8:00 a.m. And neither one of us has gotten a lot of sleep the last few days because we had a pipe explode. And was that Thursday? Yeah, it was Wednesday night the pipe exploded. Thursday morning early you were up and your brother was here and you guys ran to the store and got some stuff and you got it patched.
We got a Band-Aid on it right now.
Yeah, we have a little
more
than a Band-Aid.
I mean, some people might consider it a permanent repair, but for me, it's a Band-Aid. And
no, it's not permanent.
It's going to...
We're not closing up the wall until we get it fixed properly.
Yeah.
So Monday, that's what we're going to do. But he's not had much sleep, and tomorrow morning he has church duties, and he'll be home probably about 2 o'clock in the afternoon tomorrow.
Well, we also had the issue with the gas company coming out because they... 4 months ago, they decided we had a leak. And they were going to repair it, and they finally showed up to repair the leak.
4 months later.
You know, they had everything marked where the wires were. I knew where the wires were because I take note of these things. And anyway, they proceeded to cut through my phone line, so.
We told them to dig it out by hand, and oh no, we know what we're doing. They bring in this big giant thing with a claw on the front of it, and they're oops.
I told them where it was, but they didn't listen.
But anyway, so. Enough of that mess.
Anyway, back to happy things. Let's
let's see.
Beer barrel.
Yes, we were going to be going to the Czech Republic this year. And now this tour, the 2020 tour, is going to be put in June of 2021. So here's a song written in Prague, the Beer Barrel Polka.
Skodolaski,
in all the languages. There's a garden, what a garden, only happy faces bloom there. There's never any room there for music, or bloom there. Barolito, de cerveza, morigone, parandero. To make it the slot, tristeza, barolito, cervecero. For the holy twitch, James Gates, who here. Bunda, habichia, genita,
J.
German, and we've done it in Spanish. Now we're going to do it in its original language. Check!
Spoda laski, tero sen tobie dala. Dimie oci, nas bici vipakala. Moje mladi, uproklo tak jako sen. Nažeg nomi zbelejenom, zezimem špomenke jen. Hej!
From the 2019.
Roll that beautiful bean
roll
footage.
Roll that bean footage.
Yeah, you need to teach Scooter to say that.
Scooter today, she just said, and I say this all the time, so I'm surprised she hasn't said it before. Maybe she has said it before, but today she said it loud and clear. I didn't do it. She's such a smart little bird. I always have a guilty complex, like I've done something naughty, and it's probably
because I
have done something naughty.
Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready. Let's go to 2019, when we went to Austria, mostly Austria.
There we are. Arriving at the
Munich airport.
Fresh
hot pretzel, cold beer in the icebox. And Dieter was our driver last year. We had never met Dieter before, but we got along just perfect, like peanut butter and jelly right away. Is that the
I think that is in
In Vienna. Yeah, we got to do the horse-drawn carriage drives right at sunset. How cool was that? All the lights in Vienna come up, and oh my goodness.
Is that not Heidelberg?
Heidelberg is somewhere else. I think that was a picture of the Danube. I'm not sure. Oh, that's the night that we did the cultural exchange with the folk dance groups in the Vienna area and Unterkirchbach. And that is Jessica jumping for joy in front of the Liechtenstein castle. There's my brother showing off his beer belly. He's worked hard on that, y'all. He's very proud of it. He's also a decent photographer.
Oh, that's the sound of music.
Yeah, it's the sound of music where Maria got married. That's the wedding scene. And Ross got to sing in there, too. Somewhere there's a video of him singing in there. There he is with our tour guide there, Richard, who was another just amazing tour guide and very enthusiastic and just loves his job and loves being a priest there at the church. There's Brian with his identical twin somebody over in Austria.
Doppelganger,
yeah. And that is, I can't see it.
It's a Rotobahn.
Oh, it's a Rotobahn. Brian's feet on the Rotobahn. Yeah.
Margaret
and Dale, they really take some nice photos. That's up at Eagle's Nest over Berchtesgaden. What a pretty day. We got up there nice and early. There was still snow on the ground. That's Ron and Charlene Botts.
At the ice hole.
Yeah.
Ice cave.
Yeah, we went up to the ice cave with them. They climbed the entire thing. I can't see again. Margaret and Dale at Hallstatt, yeah. The real Hallstatt, not the one in China. And that is Christy and Kelly and Margaret and Dale on the gondola going up to the top of that mountain where we went and played in snow. And that is, Donkey and Pooh. Tammy takes Donkey and Pooh on a lot of her vacations and does journals about their adventures and all the crazy things that they do. And there's Brian and Tammy all dressed up to go down the slides in the salt mine. It's kind of cold down there, cold and humid, about 55 degrees. So you got to be dressed well for it. Let's see, what is that? Oh, that's my dad being interviewed in Kufstein on the night that we surprised our guests going to an Alpendrums concert. We had 2 hours of entertainment by these amazing guys who were just pounding and banging on everything they could think of, and the music was awesome. There we are back with that's our group picture from 2019. We were in Vienna. What a pretty night that was. Yeah, so we've had a lot of fun. That's most of the pictures that we had. And I think we have one more video, but we're not going to show it until the very end of the show. It'll actually be the end screen of our show. So we should play one more song. I don't know what we should play, though.
Well, we had a request for 99 Luftballons, which we don't
actually. You're going to do that last?
Play. I was going to do something that's more akin to what we do.
Oh, you're going to do something that we do?
I didn't say that. You did.
Oh. Somebody's going to comment on that. You know that, right? You said doo-doo. They did that last week. They said you said doo-doo.
Just don't get it confused with the German word for you, as in you.
You.
Is the word do.
Things are just a little bit too weird in the world today. Don't go out in public saying doo-doo to people, because they won't get it. Just keep it amongst us. Keep it amongst friends.
Thank you.
Jawohl. So, not exactly 99 Luftballons, but we went to outer space. Stuart, I promise, we're going to learn that song at some point. If pipes would stop breaking and cable people would quit breaking things outside, or not cable, gas people would stop breaking lines outside, and we could actually...
At least they didn't take out our cable, because otherwise we wouldn't be here tonight at all.
Yeah, yeah, we thank God they didn't take out the cable, too.
They only took out the phone line.
So that's all for tonight.
We need to maybe remind folks.
Yeah, we do. Shameless self-promotion.
We do have items for sale. We have CDs. We have hat pins. We have
T-shirts.
T-shirts.
We might even sell ourselves. If you...
That's true.
We haven't fully figured out how to do this yet because it's like 110 degrees in Texas. But we're thinking if you would like to have a backyard concert, let us know, because doing things outdoors with about 10 people kind of spread out is kind of safe. So if you have like a covered patio, a well aired out garage, it's not, you know, like the west sun coming right into it, and your neighbors don't mind a little polka music in your backyard, let us know. We might be able to work something out to come over to your house and play some tunes for you, and we can all drink beers out of the cooler and have a good old time. We are hearing that the hospitals are all getting hit again with a lot of people that got sick from the last few weeks' activities, and we pray that all those people do okay and that the hospitals are better prepared this time. They say they're better prepared, and they know what they're dealing with a little bit better. But the virus is still going around. It's still very active, and we don't know what's going to happen with the Oktoberfest season. But if you want to have a backyard party with about 10 friends, let us know, because we might be able to work something out for you. We are willing to travel about 2 hours away from Houston, somewhere that we can do a round trip and come right back home. We don't want to stay overnight in hotels. We do want to be able to come back to our home base at night just to save ourselves and save you a little bit of money. But let us know if you're interested. Otherwise,
to save our health.
Save our health, too. Yeah. Shop online. We have our shop on prostgel.com/shop. T-shirts and stuff there. And hat pins. And, of course, our tip boot is online if you have a couple of bucks to throw at us. Every little bit helps keep the lights on and keep us being able to bring you shows on Saturday nights. And if you want to see us, if you're in the Houston area, southwest side of Houston, come out to the Sauerkraut Grill. We're there most of this summer on Thursday nights. Come over and see us there as long as everybody stays healthy. And we're going to take a break. And but don't go anywhere, because we're going to show you an end screen with a nice little end video that Helmut made with us a few years ago on one of our trips.
I'm going to warn you right now. Let's just say the maybe we'll pop on for just a little bit after the video.
Okay, don't go anywhere. We'll be back shortly. Also, next week is Father's Day weekend. So dads, friends who are fathers, our own daddies, Bob Witte and Valina Weinberg, Vim Weinberg, y'all tell us what your favorite songs are, and we'll try to do all the dads' favorites for Father's Day next week. And it'll be lots of fun. So, here comes our bye-bye video.
Save that for Monday morning.
Oh,
Linda will get a load.
Have a bus for all five. I would never have to drive.
Paul Boot's gonna miss us this morning. So, travel with Lustig Tours, and that was kind of towards the end of that couple of weeks, wasn't it?
Well, that was a special bus. You enter that bus and you become an Oompa Loompa. And at the end of the trip, you turn back to your normal self.
I thought it was all the pulfriches and mashed potatoes that we ate.
Maybe so. For some reason, OBS wanted to It was taken on a camera phone where it was a narrow video, and OBS stretched it out, and I had no option of changing the format so that it would play correctly. So
there's the fun we had. So next week on the 20th is Father's Day. The 27th, we may be featuring the St. Arnold's Brewery. They contacted us just a few days ago. And Wednesday, July 1st, we also have something very special planned because we will not be playing on Saturday night, July 4th. So keep tuned in, and we hope to see you again. And until then, prost, y'all, and happy staycation.
Oh, my God.